A jolly, merry and festive greetings to everyone present. I, Pallavi Sharma, with my entire team of Ganga House, is here to wish all the parents and students on behalf of Director Sir, Usha Ma'am, Principal Ma'am and from DCM family, a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. The countdown for Christmas Day and New Year has started. Amid the pandemic, it's important that we connect and tell each other that no one is alone. So let's celebrate Christmas and New Year.
Hello everyone! I am your loving Santa. The present year was full of worries and stress, but no more worries now. Christmas is here and I will take away all your stress and pain. Ha ha ha! Relax and start enjoying the eve. Fill your heart with new hopes, happiness and optimism. God bless you all. Merry Christmas!
The weather is so pleasant and vibrant today. It's pleasing my soul.
Yes, Bhavika. It's Christmas time. The world fills with positive vibes during Christmas.
Let's watch the origin
and importance of Christmas
and celebrate this festival
from our homes only.
Merry Christmas!
Jingle bells, jingle bells, I love Christmas, and I love Santa.
Me too, but my child, do you know we call it Christmas because Jesus Christ was born that day?
Really?
No.
Please tell me a Christmas story.
About 2000 years ago, in a small town called Nazareth, there was a little house where lived a young Jewish girl named Mary. She was not married, but she was going to be real soon to a real man named Joseph. Well, one day, something amazing happened. An angel of Lord Gabriel a very important angel appeared to Mary.
Who are you?
I am Gabriel. Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. He loves you very much. God has sent me here to tell you that soon you will have a son.
A son? Really?
Yes, a son. He'll be called Jesus. He'll be called a son of God.
Mary was obedient.
I am handmaid of God. May God do with me as He wants to.
One day, Emperor Caesar Augustus said all people to pay taxes. So Joseph and Mary had to leave for Bethlehem. But all places were already occupied by the other people. Joseph ran here and there to find a suitable place to live. But all was in vain. And Mary was about to have a baby. Can you imagine? A place. No one would have expected the Son of God to be born in. It was not a palace, not some castle, and not in a fancy building either. God's Son was born in a small, humble stable. That night, Jesus was born, the Savior of the world. A bright star came up in the sky, just above the stable where Jesus was born, and the shepherds in the field saw the star. They believed that Son of God has born. So this day is celebrated as the birth of Jesus. Merry Christmas.
हो 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 कहते हुए लाल सफेद कपड़ों में बड़ी सी सफेद दाढ़ी और बालों वाले कंधे पर गिफ्ट से भरा बड़ा सा बैग लटकाए और हाथों में क्रिसमस बेल लिए हुए सेंटा को तो आप सब जानते होंगे। बच्चों के प्यारे सेंटा, जिन्हें क्रिसमस फादर भी कहा जाता है, हर क्रिसमस पर बच्चों को चॉकलेट्स गिफ्ट्स देकर बच्चों की मुस्कुराहट का कारण बनते हैं। तभी तो हर क्रिसमस पर बच्चे अपने सेंटा का बेसब्री से इंतजार करते हैं। सेंटा का आधुनिक रूप 19वीं सदी में अस्तित्व में आया। इससे पहले वो ऐसे नहीं थे। आज से करीब 1500 साल पहले जन्मे सेंट निकोलस को असली सेंटा माना जाता है। हालांकि सेंट निकोलस और जीजस के जन्म का सीधा संबंध नहीं है, फिर भी आज के समय में सेंटा क्लॉस क्रिसमस का अहम हिस्सा है। उनके बिना क्रिसमस अधूरा लगता है। बचपन से ही सेंट निकोलस की प्रभु यीशु में बहुत आस्था थी। वह बड़े होकर ईसाई धर्म के पादरी और बाद में बिशप बने। उन्हें जरूरतमंदों और बच्चों को गिफ्ट्स देना बहुत अच्छा लगता था। एक बार सेंट निकोलस ने एक गरीब की मदद उनके सॉक्स में सोने के सिक्के रखकर की। बस तभी से क्रिसमस की रात बच्चे इस उम्मीद के साथ अपने मोजे लटकाते हैं कि सुबह उनमें उनके लिए गिफ्ट्स रखे होंगे। सेंटा का जो नाम आज प्रचलित है वो निकोलस के डच नाम सिंटरक्लॉस से आया है, जो बाद में हमारा सेंटा क्लॉस बन गया।
अनवी, दैट्स सो न्यू टू मी।
इट वाज सेंट निकोलस हु स्टार्टेड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सेंटा।
यस भाविका, क्रिसमस इज एन अमेजिंग एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फेस्टिवल। Do you know each of the symbols used in Christmas has its own deep meaning?
Yeah, I know Christmas tree is very important from Christmas because it is believed to be the tree of paradise and is used to ward off evil.
I love the decoration lights used in Christmas. Decoration lights are bright and vibrant and signifies hope, happiness and safety of people.
मुझे तो gifts बहुत पसंद हैं. याद है हम जब छोटे होते थे तो हमारे मम्मी पापा सॉक्स के अंदर हमारे गिफ्ट्स रख दिया करते थे. पता है क्रिसमस में गिफ्ट्स का रिवाज कैसे आया? क्रिसमस में हमारे बड़े छोटे बच्चों को जीसस के जन्म पर अगरबत्तियां दिया करते थे, जिसे उनके जीवन में सुख शांति का प्रतीक माना जाता था. तभी से क्रिसमस पर गिफ्ट्स के लेन देन का चलन है.
I love the concept of mistletoe in Christmas. You know, Bhavika, it is an aerial parasite which does not have its own roots. Without the tree, the mistletoe would die. It is a symbol of God's love for us. As mistletoe can't survive without the tree, same as humans can't survive without the love of God.
Santa doesn't really mean that you will come with a red hat, with white beards and a sack full of gifts. You need to look around yourself who needs your help, and you can simply help them and be their Santa. So be a Santa to the people, to yourself, to the nature or to the animals around.
Adhya, where is your chocolate?
Mummy, मम्मी आपको चॉकलेट खानी थी तो मैंने दे दी.
Okay, very good, beta, very good. God bless you.
Thank you, Miss Mauji, for helping us every day. ये शहरों का सन्नाटा, ये शहरों का सन्नाटा बता रहा है। इंसान ने कुदरत को नाराज बहुत किया है।
Year 2020, what it took and whether it gave us anything back, we all must have faced some difficulties, bad time, health issues, small or big problems in a life. These problems must have given us some pain or loss, and slowly, as time passed, it's all went away. After some point of time, if we look back, then we realize that we gain a lot much from that difficult phase of a life. It might have changed a life track to a better one. So, there may be a learning in any problem being faced by us. But is it true for Corona? We know that Corona created a havoc in life of almost all the citizens in this entire world. It took so much from us. But whether it gave us anything back, let's look at it. First of all, let's see what are the problems we are facing due to Corona. People from all countries are very badly affected. Lakhs of people died. Thousands are still in hospitals. And there is danger looming on all of us. Secondly, world economy is in bad shape. Businesses are trying to recover. Lot many people lost their jobs. Many people do not have savings. Third is the worst affected are people who are laborers. Migrant people who come to work in big cities. No jobs, no income. They are going back to their native places. Entertainment and enjoyment are part of our life. We did not go for shopping, malls, movies, hotels, social functions in these months. It seemed to be lost to many. Religious places are closed. Lastly, holidays in schools and colleges. Educationists are worried, but children may be happy due to this.
January of this year 2020 began with a brand new decade with full of optimism. But as the summer progresses, most of us started wondering this year as the worst year of their lives. A string of wildfires engulfed Australia, followed shortly by Iranian regime shooting down the Ukrainian airliner PS752. The stretch of bad events kicked off the year's optimism. The other unfortunate events included the earthquakes in Turkey and Caribbean, a locust swarm outbreak in East Africa, and the deaths of renowned personalities one of the other. This is the list of things we lost. Now let's look at what we getting in return.
गीता में स्पष्ट शब्दों में लिखा है, निराश न होना, कमजोर तेरा वक्त है, तू नहीं।
So let's see what we have gathered during this time. After a long, we are spending really good time with our family, playing games, remembering old friends, talking to them, doing things which we did not do because of time and work pressure, exercise, yoga, paintings, and much more. In above list, we saw loss of entertainment as one item. But if we seriously think, it's really a loss. In fact, we realize that we can live without such things in our lives. Less expenses, more savings, better health, and a good life. Schools are closed and it gives boost to e-learning. Good contents from many parts of the world are reaching to millions in every corner of the world. It is less expensive too. Nature is now clean and pure. Pollution is very less, and the most important thing is Corona helped us in meeting ourselves. It helped in introducing to our own identity. Those who are doing meditation or sitting quiet and thinking they must have realized this what is right, what is wrong. We are able to decide it in much better way. Some feel that meditation is for people about 50 to 60 years of age. In fact, it should be compulsory for children above 12 years too.
Hi everyone. Today, I am going to tell you about the thing which I have learned the most during this coronavirus pandemic, and that is the mass hysteria that has been caused by the media. I am reminded of Seneca's famous quote that says that we suffer more in imagination than in reality. We suffer more in imagination than in reality because the fact is that most of us are suffering more in imagining what coronavirus will do to us than actually what it will do to us.
From this entire experience of coronavirus that has swept the entire world, and rightfully so, and I started asking myself the same question, that what I have learned about this entire coronavirus thing. According to me, the world is now global in a way that we have never experienced before. This virus happened in a very small town, in a very small city of Wuhan in China, and now impacted the entire world. Something that started in a very small town in some obscure part of the entire country out there is now affecting the entire world. And that will tell you how connected, how global the world is now.
The biggest lesson that I have learned through this entire experience is there is no plan that eventually works out. Go back 3 months. Every company, every smart individual, every capable individual on earth would have had a plan for the next quarter, for the next 6 months, for the next 1 year, and for the next 5 years. At bang, happens something that we can, the Black Swan event. Every plan that has been made by the smartest people out there has gone for a toss. What does this tell us? It tells us that it's not the one with the plan that wins, but the one with the ability to change their plan whenever required that wins. The ones with the ability to maneuver and to be agile whenever the time is required are the ones who will eventually win this plan. It is not the plan that wins, it's the agility to change the plan, to move the plan that wins.
I hope all of you are safe. I hope all of you are washing your hands as much as you can. But it's a beautiful time to reflect on how adversities really teach us something that we have never stopped and paused and thought about. And this is my lesson from the entire experience of what the world is going through.
वक्त आपका है, वक्त आपका है, चाहे तो सोना बना लो, चाहे तो सोना बना लो, या सोने में गुजार दो. To sum up, we need to realize that whatever we do in excess in our lives, crossing boundaries, ignoring what is right and wrong, then in such circumstances, nature has its own way of teaching us a lesson. In name of too much materialism, economics GDP, stock market, fashion, status, ego, or food or other habits, all this resulted in so much pain to other humans. Billions of animals and birds are being slaughtered. Huge pollution and so many other things. We never realized that we have to have some principles. It's time to think what we'll leave for our next generation. Just material wealth, is that enough? Let's think and take corrective actions. Lastly, stay healthy, stay positive. This too shall pass. Let's pray very soon this darkness comes to an end. There'll be a better tomorrow, more peace for all living beings. Thank you.
Hope is the only way to overcome the present sorrows. For this, we need more and more of blessings. And blessings become more important when it comes from our loved ones. So, I request our respected director, sir, our honorable principal, ma'am, Ms. Renu Verma, and our beloved coordinator, Latika Channa, ma'am, to shower their blessings upon us.
Dear parents, teachers, and my dear lovely children, I wish all of you happy Christmas and happy New Year in advance. I know that your last year was little challenging, but I'm hopeful that coming year will bring prosperity again and you will enjoy it. You will again come to school. We'll again sit together. Let me hope for the best. I wish all of you will work hard and plan a resolution for the next year and do the best from your side. All the best.
My dear parents, teachers, and lovely students, at the very outset, on behalf of Team TCM, let me extend to you all greetings for a Merry Christmas and a bright and prosperous New Year 2021. Each year, we look forward to these two occasions of celebrations with great joy and enthusiasm. But this year, due to the deadly corona pandemic, the festive fervor would and should certainly remain somewhat restricted. The year 2020 has indeed been a challenging year, and the end to the pandemic is still not in sight. In these challenging times, we, the member of TCM family, not only pray for your good health and happiness, but also pray for the recovery and prosperity of your extended families. Personally, I hope these two occasions bring all-round joy and well-being for you all and usher bright rays of hope and positivity for the year ahead. While you celebrate, do obey and comply with the guidelines given by the Health Ministry for COVID-related instructions. Rejoice, but remember safety first. Follow all precautions to stay corona-free and not help to spread and bring in another surge. The vaccine is still well out of our reach. So let us celebrate Christmas and New Year with some restraints this time. Once again, wishing you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Take care. God bless.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you. What the New Year brings to you will depend a great deal on what you bring to the New Year. You may be whatever you resolve to be. Here, we have our teachers and students going to present their resolutions for the year 2021.
कोई कर सकता है तो मैं क्यों नहीं, क्या है उनमें ऐसा जो मुझ में नहीं। अगर कोई कर सकता है तो मैं क्यों नहीं, क्या है उनमें ऐसा जो मुझ में नहीं। झांक ले अपने भीतर खुद से आ पूछ ले, कैसी चाहिए जिंदगी खुली आंखों से देख ले। मुट्ठियों को खींच गए, सांसों को खींच गए, मुट्ठियों को खींच गए, सांसों को खींच गए, सबसे टकराने को शिखर।
कैसी भी मेरे हौसलों से कम है, अंधेरों को चीर देंगे इतना दम है। मुश्किलें हो कैसी भी मेरे हौसलों से कम है, अंधेरों को चीर देंगे इतना दम है। आओ हाथ बढ़ाए कुछ करके दिखाना है, सारे बहानों को आज से आग लगाना है, मुट्ठियों को भींच कर